Hi everyone, good morning all of you. Today we will discuss one important and very easy one, mathematical phenomena called how to calculate percentage changes. What is the meaning of first percentage changes and how the questions will come in physics? That basically we need to understand. So generally you have learned in lower classes the percentage change. Like consider one quantity x. So the value of x is, let's say, 2. Now after x value became 4. So this is called initial value. This is called final value. Like in 2015 your height is 4 foot. Now your height is 5.5 foot, suppose. So 4.5 foot is your initial height. Let's take H1. Or HI, and after some time your height became 5.5 foot. This is the initial height, this is the final height over a duration of period. Then the value got increased. The value got increased. In some cases, like before 1 year, your weight is 60 kg. Now your weight is 52 kg. It got reduced. So here this is the initial weight. This is the final weight. Here volume got reduced. So value may increase. Sorry, volume may increase. Value may decrease. Anything can happen. In such situations, we can say two things, that is fractional change and percentage change. What is that? Fractional change and percentage change. So here fractional change, also called as relative change, that is delta x by x. X is the quantity, like height or weight, anything. X can be any quantity. So the initial value of x is x1 and it changed to x2. So the change in x, that is delta x, is x2 minus x1, and this x is initial value. So the ratio of change by initial value, change by initial value, this is called relative or fractional change. There is a fraction. That's why it is called fractional change. Or the change is related with initial value, relating. The relation between change and initial value. That's why it is also called relative change. You can say anything. Either relative change or fractional change. Now, if you multiply relative or fractional change with 100, that is percentage change. This is the simple formula. But while calculating questions, it is not that simple. So the method we need to understand. But one thing is clear, that when the value of a quantity increases or decreases by some amount, so that change by initial value, we call it as fractional or relative change. And if you multiply with 100, you will get percentage change. This type of questions, in what way we get in physics, that we need to understand. One of the most easiest as well as important one for the entrance purpose. So please try to understand it. Not just in one chapter, many chapters you can get the questions based on this one. So here, but they will not ask you simply one value changed from 100 to 300 and find the percentage change. Like final is 300, initial is 100 by 100 into 100. So that 100 cancel, 200%. It is not that simple. It is not that simple they will give. So what way they will give is, they always ask percentage changes for one quantity which is depending on another quantity. Like for example let's take two quantities. One is y, another is x. Now y depends on x. Y depends on x. In what way it can depend? Any way. It can depend on any way. Like for example, y proportional to minus 1 by x, y proportional to x, or y proportional to x square, or y proportional to root x. Anything. Any relation can be given. Not just this one. Y may be proportional to 1 by x square also. For example, I am telling you. In physics, you know one formula, kinetic energy of a body moving with some velocity v. What is the kinetic energy formula? Half m v square. So here half is constant, 1 by 2 is constant, and if you move the body, mass does not change, only what will change? Velocity. So here mass is also constant, so here velocity changes so that kinetic energy changes. So for one particular particle, as velocity changes, kinetic energy changes. So that now in this relation, mass and 2 both are constants. So that you can write the relation like k proportional to v square. K proportional to v square. So here it is like this. Like now, y is k, x is v. As v changes, k changes. As v changes, k also changes. So now, in such situations, what type of questions they will ask is, they will ask you like this. Velocity of the particle. If the velocity of the particle increased or decreased by 100%, suppose. The data what they have given, the velocity of the particle may increase, they can give, or may decrease by 100%. So they will ask you to calculate what is the percentage change in kinetic energy. Because when velocity changes, kinetic energy also changes. So that's why you can apply here percentage changes. To apply that, what method we will take? See here. Every time, whenever they give questions related to percentage change, they will ask two quantities. They'll ask
two quantities. I, you will have definitely one relation in physics or one formula for those two relations, because they will not give k equal to half mv square. They will give the question in this manner. The kinetic energy percentage change you need to calculate when velocity got increased by 200%. Then you should understand that they are relating kinetic energy and velocity. Then you need to search for the formula related to these two, that is k equal to half mv square. And then you will understand that the remaining quantities which are constant you can remove and you can make the proportionality relation. So this is the first step. After that, what you have to do? First I'll explain general method. Then we'll go for this example. Just to make you understand how the physics relations can come in this form, I explained this example. Or else, one more example also I'll give you so that you can understand better. Now, you have studied about motion under gravity in motion chapter. Nagarjuna sir taught you. Where if you drop a particle, free fall, if you drop a particle from certain height, h, this is the ground. A particle dropped from certain height, h, then it will come down so that its velocity slowly increases. And before, just before hitting the ground, the velocity of the particle is given by v equal to under root 2gh. Under root 2gh. So, here 2 is constant, g is constant. So, what relation you can make? V proportional to root h, like this. Now, y is v, x is h. If you drop from this much of height, the velocity is something. But if you drop from this much of height, then height got increased. Then velocity also increases. But same thing what they will ask you is, if the height of the free falling body increased by 300%, then what is the corresponding change in velocity just before hitting the ground? So immediately after reading the question, you should understand that this question is related to free fall. Then you have to take the formula on your own. Then you need to make the relation on your own, so that you can solve such questions. But what is the method, we'll understand now. So this way, the very first step is understand the question. Read the question properly and understand from which chapter it is related and which two quantities they are relating, like kinetic energy, velocity, velocity and height. Any relation they can give from any chapter. So that, what is the next thing you have to do is, always there are two quantities. There is one thing we will consider as y, another is x. So that y depends on x or x depends on y. Then what is the first thing you need to understand is, you take one set of values y1, x1, y1, x1 as initial values for y and x. Now they will mention like either y or x, it increased or decreased by some percentage. Suppose they mentioned x increased by some percentage, so that x value becomes something x2. We don't know. Then y also changes.
then you take the corresponding y value y2. So this is initial set of values, this is final set of values. Now you first take care of for which quantity they have given percentage change value. Suppose they have given for x, percentage change means what? X2 minus x1 by x1 into 100. The x increased means you take plus. So increased means you take plus. Decreased means you take negative. But percentage change means what? Final minus initial by initial into 100. They will give something. Let's take suppose increased by 100. Then you will take plus 100. Or decreased by 200. Then you will take minus 200. So that from here you will get the relation between x1 and x2. You will get the relation between x1 and x2. So you will get the relation between x1 and x2. Then you can get the relation between y1 and y2. How? That is, see, suppose according to the given question, you got the relation like y proportional to x square. Then y2 by y1 equal to x2 by x1 whole square. Because y proportional to x square. Or else, proportionality, when it will come, there must be some constant. Y equal to, let's say, kx square. K is some constant. Initially, x1, y1, substitute. Y1 equal to kx1 square. Finally, they change it to y2, x2. So, y2 equal to kx2 square. So that if you divide these two, y2 by y1 equal to kx2 square by kx1 square equal to kk get cancelled. So x2 by x1 whole square. X2 by x1 whole square. So here only, let me just tell you some power relations, formulas related to powers. X power m into x power n, x power m plus n, x power m by x power n equal to x power m minus n, and x power m whole power n equal to x power m into n. Then 1 by x power n equal to, this will become x power minus n. When you take from denominator to numerator, or numerator to denominator, then power changes from plus to minus or minus to plus. So x power m equal to 1 by x power minus m, and x power m y power m equal to x into y whole power m, or x power m by y power m equal to x by y whole power m. Like x2 square, x1 square, power is same. Then I can write x by y whole power m. So this way, these power formulas also helpful in solving questions. Very important. Simple things, but please remember carefully. That's it. So that you will get the relation. Now, they have given percentage change for x. Then you will get the relation between x1 and x2. From this relation, you can get the relation between y1 and y2. Then y2 minus y1 by y1 into 100 equal to, you will get percentage change in y. What? Percentage change in y. So
let me explain with one example, complete example with particular values, then only you can understand properly. So let me take one particular relation. So I will consider one relation that y is proportional to root x, and they have given x value increased by 300%. Then find percentage change in y. This is the question. So they have given the relation, or after they have given question, when you take the physics formula, you got the relation between the two quantities given is like one is proportional to square root of another one. Just one example. Relation is not fixed. It can be anything. Now, see, as I told you, here they have given relation, so don't worry. But usually in physics question, you have to take this relation. You have to take this relation. That is the first step. So the first step is, take the relation between y and x. Then y1, x1 initial set of values, they change to y2, x2. And next step, they will give percentage change for one quantity. Then you can find relation between initial and final quantity, final values of that quantity. What I am telling? They will give percentage change for one quantity so that you can find a relation between initial and final values of that quantity. Like in the given question, they have given percentage change in y. Percentage change in x. So percentage change in x means what? x2 minus x1 by x1 into 100. How much they have given? 300. So 0, 0, 0 cancel. Or you take this 100 this side if you get confused. Then x2 minus x1 by x1 equal to 3 implies. Cross multiply it. x2 minus x1 equal to 3x1. This will become multiplier. Take this x1 this side. So x2 equal to 3x1 plus x1 equal to 4x1. So you got the relation between x1 and x2. As I told, find the relation between initial and final values of that quantity. Then what is the next step? Take the ratio of initial and final values according to the relation. Like here, what is the relation? Y proportional to x. So that y2 by y1 equal to under root x2 by x1. Or else, if you feel difficult with square root, you remove the square root. See, y proportional to x, root x. Then what I will write is, I will square both sides.
So y square proportional to root x whole square. Square square root cancel. So y square proportional to what? X. Either you take this or this. Now, here if you take y2 by y1 whole square equal to x2 by x1. Anything you can take. So that after taking this, substitute the relation which you got, where x2 is how much? 4x1. So x2 is 4x1 by x1. X1, x1 get cancelled. Y2 by y1 whole square equal to 4. So y2 by y1 equal to 2. So y2 by y1 equal to 2. So using the relation, you can get the relation between y2 and y1. They have given relation for x. You found the relation for y. Then finally, percentage change in y. What is that? Y2 minus y1 by y1 into 100. Y2, y1. So here y1, here y1 is there. So always substitute for y2. What is y2 here? Y2 is 2y1. So 2y1 minus y1 by y1 into 100. 2y1 minus y1, y1 by y1 into 100, y1, y1. So how much? 100%. So the percentage change in y, we got 100. When x increased by 300, then y increased by only just 100%. So this way, you can understand the percentage change questions. Right? So, the method, first one. When they give a question related to percentage changes, know the quantities which two are they are trying to relate. Then take the relation and make the relation from the physics in this manner, proportionality. Then take set of values, initial set, final set. Then they will give the percentage change for any one quantity. Then they will ask you for the other quantity, so that the quantity for which they will give percentage change, like here for x they have given, then you will get the relation between x1 and x2. Then you can get the relation between y1 and y2. If they give percentage change in y, then you will get the relation between y1 and y2. Then you can get the relation between x2 and x1. Like, see, suppose in the same question, they have given in another manner. Like, now let's take, another way. See here, y now increased by 300%, they have given. Now they are telling y increased by 300%. Then you will take immediate relation y2 minus y1 by y1 into 100 equal to 300. Increased means plus. So 0, 0 again cancelled. So y2 minus y1 equal to 3y1. So y2 equal to 3y1. This it comes this side. Plus y1 equal to 4y1. Now you got the relation between y2 and y1. Now. So they have given percentage change for y. So you got relation between y1 and y2. Then using this relation or that relation. See, take this relation suppose. Now y2 by y1 equal to under root x2 by x1. So y2 4y1 by y1 equal to under root x2 by x1. y1, y1 cancel. Now square both sides. 4 square equal to root x2 by x1 whole square. Square square root cancel. So that 16 equal to x2 by x1. Now what is x2? 16x1. If they give percentage change in y, then you can find y1, y2 relation so that you can get the relation between x1 and x2. Then they will ask you in the question what now? They have given for y. They will ask you for x. So now percentage change in x equal to x2 minus x1 by x1 into 100 equal to 16x1 minus x1 by x1 into 100. 16 minus 1, 15x1 by x1 into 100. So how much? 1500%. 1500%. So this is what? This is what? The percentage change calculation questions. Like, let us take one physics example. The question, pure physics question, let's take. Kinetic energy of a particle increased by 50%. How much? 50%. Then find percentage change in its linear momentum. So the question is kinetic energy and linear momentum. I told you, when they give the question related to percentage change, the first step, find which two quantities they are asking, kinetic energy and linear momentum. Get the physics formula relating those two things. So kinetic energy, what is the kinetic energy formula? Half mv square. What is the linear momentum? Mass into velocity. But we need the relation between K and P. So that, see, V equal to, or bring this mass this side, P by M equal to V. So V value, you can substitute as P by M. So K will become half M, V is P by M whole square. Half into M into P square by M square. M cancel. Now, kinetic energy equal to P square by 2M. Of course, in work energy power chapter, you might have studied this formula already. Now, if you take the formula related to kinetic energy and linear momentum, then the remaining quantities must be constant. Like, what are the remaining quantities? 2 and mass. Both are constant. So what you can write? K proportional to P square. So this is the first step. Take the suitable formula and find the relation between the given two quantities like kinetic energy and linear momentum. What is the next step? Next step is they will give percentage change for one quantity. Here they have given for kinetic energy. But before that, you need to take set of initial and final values. Always take initial value as k1, p1, means 1, 1. Then they change it to 2, k2, p2. Then, k proportional to p square means k2 by k1 equal to p1 by p2 whole square. Implies. Now, here there is four quantities and they have given percentage change for kinetic energy. Then what we will do? K2 minus K1 by K1 into 100. Percentage change in kinetic energy. P
P2 minus P1 by P1 into 100. Percentage change in linear momentum. This we need to find. This they have given. So 50%. So this is 50%. Or just 50. Here, increased they have given. So plus. If they give decrease, then take minus. Don't forget that. Now, K2 minus K1 equal to 50 by 100. 100 you bring this side. Then 5 2s are 1 by 2. So that K2 minus K1 equal to K1 by 2. K1 you bring this side. Then take this K1 this side. K1 plus K1 by 2. 3K1 by 2. So according to the given data, you found the initial and final values of kinetic energy. Because they have given percentage change for kinetic energy only. If they give percentage change for linear momentum, then you will substitute here and you will get relation between P1, P2. But here we found K1, K2 relation. Then using this relation, K2 by K1 equal to P2 by P1 whole square. So K2 by K1 is how much? From here, K2, bring this K1 this side, equal to 3 by 2. K1 I brought this side. So this is 3 by 2 equal to P2 by P1 whole square. Now, apply square root both sides. So square root square cancels. So that P2 by P1 equal to root of 3 by 2. Now P2 equal to root of 3 by 2 times P1. So from K1 K2 relation, I found the relation between P1 P2. Then the final step, after getting P1 P2 relation, the percentage change in P equal to P2 minus P1 by P1 into 100 equal to, I told you already, always substitute for P2 second final value. So P2 root of 3 by 2 P1 minus P1 by P1 into 100. Last two classes we discussed about the calculation part only. Here also you need to take care of calculation. So root 3 by 2 minus 1 into P1. I took P1 common by P1 into 100. So P1 got cancelled equal to root of 3 by 2 minus 1 to 100. So this value, if you calculate, what you will get? Percentage change in linear momentum. So here they have given for kinetic energy and you found for linear momentum. So now here this is one value, but we need to take final value. Root 3 is how much? 1.732. Root 2 is what? 1.414 minus 1 into 100. Into 100. Now, so here, point cancel, same. Now, 1732 minus 1414 by 1414 into 100. So, here, if you subtract, let me just take here. So 1732 minus 1414. So how much you will get? 318. 318. So that divided by 1414 into 100. Now
So just try to take approximation, or else of course when I said about approximation, try to take it in this way for simple calculation. Here I am telling in detail, but if you take approximation, see 1.7 you can take approximately, 1.732 as 1.7, 1.414 as 1.4 into 100, so point cancels, so 2 7s are 2 50s are, so 17 into 50, 17 5s are 85 by 7, 1 2 1 point something. So approximately how much? 121%. So approximate value. So if the, they will not give options like 119, 120, 125 something. They will give some far values only. If unluckily if they give, then you have to take care everything. But 99.9% they will not give. So that when decimals comes, try to take approximation so that it will become easier. So this way, so you need to calculate percentage change questions. So the method is important. You can apply for any question. And most of the times, they will give questions such that calculation becomes easier because your method is big. Usually I am telling. So please try to take care of method step by step. So that I will give assignment based on these questions only, so that you can practice and you can understand well. So these questions, these kind of questions can be asked in any chapter, right? So we'll continue in the similar way in the coming class with another mathematical phenomena. Like today we discussed about percentage change calculation based questions, that too in physics, right? Thank you so much.